Hey CC fam, welcome back to my channel. Today is Reset Wednesday. So that's when I help uplift, encourage, and help you get over that hard bump we call life and motivate you and inspire you to keep pushing. So if you are new, consider subscribing and hitting the bell next to it. Make a ding so you won't miss a thing. All right, let's jump into it. So today's topic will be unworthy. And I want to talk about some situations and things we bump into in life where it makes us feel unworthy. And I just want to help us get centered and put that foundation back in place to remind you that you are worthy and don't let nobody else tell you. So let's jump into it. So I've been noticing in these social media streets, I've been stumbling on some uncomfortable situations where there's a sender and a recipient, and the recipient in somehow, some way is intimidated, and the outcome, they walk out feeling unworthy. And I want to remind you, hence I'm being very dramatic today. But I want to remind you to shift your crown in life and remind yourself that you are worthy. As I network and everything like that with opportunities that I seek, I constantly validate myself and tell myself, I am worthy. I belong at the table. I don't want you to present yourself in life like God has not equipped you with the things inside of you, in your mind, in your skill set, your upbringing, that you are not worthy of life's opportunities. So let's take dating for instance. Men, you have to be cautious on your compassion and how you give off an arrogant aura, and vice versa. Ladies, we really have to figure out what energy and our body language, how we are giving off, and make sure we're not giving ourselves off in a cocky and condescending way where you discourage others, and eventually somebody else will be the recipient of their unworthiness and their misplaced anger because of you. So always operate in love. Know who you are. Gentlemen, please just be careful. Be gentle with these ladies. And never discourage anybody and make them feel they're unworthy of your presence. Even if you are not interested, there's a smooth and kind way that you can decline, respectfully decline, without hurting someone's feelings and making them feel unworthy. And same thing for you ladies. Second, I want to talk about how some of us have an attitude of unworthiness with networking. Now to me, networking is the biggest asset that you can have, where God gives you that as a launching pad for your opportunities. So you have to mix and mingle with people, with companies. And I want you to stop acting like you are not worthy to be at the table. Even Solange and Tyler Perry says that sometimes you have to create your own table. You can't wait for other people to invite you and give you a chair, a seat at their table. You have to create your own. But amongst networking, I don't want you to walk in the room as a groupie or as someone you feel uncomfortable or you're discouraged or you're a little shy of ruffling feathers. No, you belong in that room. God put you there, not them. And God is going to give you that opportunity. So I want you to adjust your crown and you walk in there with your head held high, confident, not cocky, confident as ever, because you belong there. God has been setting this up for you. So don't mess up this opportunity walking in as woe is me, head held down, and you don't feel worthy of being at the table. Let's stop that now. You are worthy to be at that table, to have the opportunity to network amongst this one and that one. You, my dear, are worthy of all God's blessings. Don't you forget that. Now, let's talk about the workforce and interacting with corporations and you're trying to grow. Before you step in the room, you got to validate yourself. If you got to go to the bathroom and do a minute mantra in that mirror and look at yourself and you tell yourself, I am worthy of this job. I'm worthy of this opportunity. I'm worthy of this partnership with this brand. Whatever it is, the universe and God is ready to open up that opportunity. Also, brace yourself that you may be too equipped for networking. God may not want you to work or you being the borrower, you lending your knowledge, you're lending your expertise. So sometimes God have to detour you to remind you of your worth and prove your worthiness all over again and show you a new side to you to let you know you gotta lean and depend on me. Because I equipped you and make you worthy to go above and beyond people's expectations, above all that we can ask or think. So I don't want you to be sitting, twiddling your fingers, waiting on somebody else to give you an upgrade. You are worthy and you are well equipped of giving yourself the upgrade. But if you are climbing that ladder and you want to network and be in the midst of great people, great companies in the room, always, like if you go to a mixer or something like that or networking event, walk in that room and you own it. I do it every day. Before I hit the door, I own it within myself in my own space. And after I encounter people, that's my prayer for you all and for myself, that I inspire people. That is the underlining of confidence. It's not to intimidate, it's to inspire. So walk in there worthy and inspire people that they are worthy too. So the underlining message of unworthiness is you contemplating, or you are confused about God's power. God equips you and he gives you the power to overcome obstacles and life's hardships. So I don't ever want you to walk ever, whether it's an opportunity or, you know, some kind of upgrade and God is preparing you and creating a path for you to go beyond where you are right now. Don't ever walk into it feeling unworthy, because that's a slap in God's face. That's a slap to everybody who poured into you. So always, if nothing else, you be confident and you are worthy. You are worthy of a happy life. You are worthy of a happy spouse. You are worthy of a happy family situation. You are worthy of a great job opportunity. You are worthy to be a CEO. You are worthy to be a part and be amongst the people and work in the room and growing your network. You are worthy, and don't let anybody, no company, sabotage you or manipulate your intellect as far as your worthiness, or people or men or women, whatever it is. Understand the power you have inside of you. and validate yourself in God. And don't you ever forget, you are worthy. I hope that blessed you all. I felt that myself. And again, adjust your crown, honeys. And don't you ever forget. So, yes, always remember that confidence is a lifestyle. And don't you dare walk out that door without it. I love you all so much. And I'll see you next week, okay?